Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. I am so very, very excited to be sharing this wonderful news with you that you've already heard about, I'm sure, but I'm going to explain to you exactly what it is. And what am I talking about? I'm talking about Kerning. And what is Kerning? Well, I'm going to show you exactly what it is in Cricut Design Space. It's coming in the next update. You may have it already. If not, you will get it very, very soon. If you are new to my channel, please type new in the comments. I want to get to meet you. If you don't know who I am, my name is Paul from Scissors Paper Paul on Instagram, Facebook, and on YouTube. And I'm here to share all of my Cricut knowledge and expertise with you so that you can master these incredible machines and products. And ultimately, I want you to make beautiful things. As always, if you like this tutorial, please, please, please give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, do that as well, and then you won't miss out on any of my content each and every week. So, do you know what Kerning is? Let's take a look. Kerning is actually here to find when you get the update, you'll have this great little pop-up, Kerned Fonts. It's saying space matters. And why does it matter? Because Kerning is the space between your letters when you're typing text that you want to cut, print, whatever the case may be. And as we know in Cricut Design Space, if we have a beautiful scripty font, does it kern or join all together automatically? No, it does not. Well, actually, now it does exactly that. And let's take a look. Jumping into Cricut Design Space, I've got a blank canvas and I'm just going to go to the left-hand side and click on text. So let's type some text. Kerning is now in Cricut Design Space. And I'm going to resize this. I'm also going to align it to the center, but I'm going to just resize it to 11.5 inches or around 30 centimeters, just so that we can see it all on one screen and also on the mat when we go to cut, so that you can see a couple of really cool tips and tricks. So the first thing that we want to do is we want to change this font to a really nice script font. So I'm going to go up to font and I'm going to click on the down arrow. And then what I'm going to see is by default, only kerned fonts are showing. So if I want to see other fonts that don't kern automatically, I can uncheck that box and that will change the results that I want. But I'm going to leave it checked. And then I'm just going to call that as well. You've got a few options here. We've got all fonts. So this includes everything that I've downloaded or have installed automatically on my device, or system, which are specifically those fonts that are downloaded and available on the specific device, or I've got my Cricut fonts. So I'm going to go with Cricut font, and I'm just going to have a look down the page at all these lovely fonts, and I really love this one. This Alyssa stencil script. It's really beautiful, and it's super cute. I should also call out that on the top right-hand side here, we also have some other filters. So these have always been there. So if you want to see a multi-layer, single layer, a font with a writing style so that you can print, you can also choose these options on the right as well. So I'm going to choose this beautiful Alyssa stencil script and look what happens. Ta-da! And I'm going to zoom in a little bit more so we can see it. It is all connected as we would expect it to see. So previously there would have been gaps between every single letter. Now, a couple of things to keep in mind. Of course, with script fonts in the past, they are not welded together, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to zoom in so you can see exactly what I'm talking about. And I'm also going to change the color so it'll be a little bit easier to see. Choose this lovely green. But what we can see is here where the letters are joined, there are cut lines. So in the past, when we've connected these together, we would go down to the bottom right and we would click weld. And then we can see those cut lines have now disappeared and this is all going to cut as one beautiful smooth cut. And that's exactly what we want to happen. So you can do that. Or now with these particular fonts that have this automatic kerning, we can see the cut lines are back. I've clicked undo. What I'm going to do now is I'm actually going to go up and I'm going to click make it. And I want you to see what happens when it goes through to the mat. Now I'm going to zoom in so you can see this a little bit better. Look what's happened. It's automatically welded because it was kerning. It's automatically decided, hey, I want to cut this in one beautiful, smooth cut and not have all those little cutouts, and it's done all the heavy lifting for me. So I hope that makes sense. I hope you got something out of that. If you have any questions at all, as always, please ask me in the comments and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. But I think this is just a wonderful feature. It's something that we have been wanting for an incredibly long time, and now it is here. Again, you saw me use the filters where the default was Kerning fonts on. If you can't find the font that you're looking for, turn the filter off and make sure you're seeing all of the different results. But again, if you like this feature, give me a thumbs up. And again, let me know in the comments what you think. So have a great day, and I look forward to seeing you next time. Take care. Bye.